In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you some of my secrets to coming up with Instagram Reels content, especially ones that I know already have the potential to go viral. If you like art and entrepreneurship type videos, make sure to like this video, jingle all my bells and buttons for new videos every Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays. My name is Janet, I'm an ex-Disney artist turned independent creator, and I've managed to grow my Instagram account to over 49K followers. Most of which were gained through using these tactics. So let's get started. Let's start with coming up with ideas. This might seem counterintuitive, but you need to be using TikTok. Whether Instagram likes it or not, TikTok is where a lot of the Instagram Reels and trends are coming from. Instagram Reels is basically people repurposing their TikTok content to grow their Instagram account. So the way you mine or search for trends needs to be on TikTok because that's where it's coming out first. I've said this once and I'll say it before, whatever app that you want to be growing on, you need to be spending at least an hour every single day researching on that app and figuring out which content is trending, what do people want to watch, etc., etc. So the way I was able to grow very, very fast on TikTok and then Instagram, I would spend at least an hour. And trust me, I was a little addicted to TikTok. It was a lot more than just an hour. Every single day researching and watching and genuinely enjoying TikTok. And what you do is you pay attention to what sounds are constantly being used and what trends are being shown to you multiple times. So if you hear the same sound being played over and over again, that is a hot sound that you should be using on your own videos. And I've tried this multiple times. It always translates over to Instagram. And 9 times out of 10, the trend hasn't reached Instagram yet. Instagram tends to always be a little bit late, by a few days to a week at least. So if you are mining your content ideas from TikTok, you will be ahead of the trend on Instagram, which means you will most likely get a lot of engagement. My second IG Reels tip is to define your ICA. ICA is business speak for ideal customer avatar. Basically, what it means is you need to know exactly what kind of person you want to reach. Usually, it's someone who is exactly like yourself. If you're familiar with some of my other videos, I've talked a little bit about niching down before. Niching down can really help your Instagram grow and grow really, really fast. So, for example, my Instagram account is my art account, and I typically post mostly just my art on there. I'm not really going to be posting too many random other stuff. But there is a danger to niching down too small, because if you do end up niching down to, let's say, an art account, you might be pigeonholed to only being able to post about art and nothing else, because that audience followed you for your art and nothing else. So if you end up getting bored of posting art content and you want to post about something different, you probably won't get much engagement on that kind of post, which isn't great because that really limits what kind of content you are able to create, because we all want to grow and become better content creators, artists, whatever it is. We don't want to get bored at what we do. So instead of niching down too specifically, I would really pinpoint who your ICA is. Who is this person? Is it a woman? Is it a man? How old are they? What are they interested in? Because most people have multiple different kinds of interests. What kind of lifestyle do they live or aspire to live? That way you can become more of a lifestyle content creator rather than someone who's known specifically for one niche. The caveat is you will grow a little bit slower because not everyone is going to be interested in art and plants and cooking or whatever it is. But if you are successful with creating a lifestyle Instagram account, let's say, that kind of audience is a lot more valuable to brands and people trying to do collaborations because the engagement tends to be a lot higher than just a simple art account. Before I move on to my next tips, comment down below if you've used Instagram Reels and if they've actually helped you grow or not. Let me know. My third tip has to do with creation of your Reels. And this tip was a game changer when I realized everyone was doing this. And it's to edit off the app. A lot of people will film something and then take their finger off the record button and then film something else to basically edit in camera. But the thing is, most of the big Instagrammers and TikTokers and YouTubers, they don't edit on the app. They edit on apps like Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro or anything else really, because it gives you a lot more control and you can really perfect the end reel or the end TikTok. If a lot of you don't know this, a lot of influencers don't actually take their photos on their phone, nor do they record their video on their phone. A lot of them use a pretty high quality, expensive camera and expensive editing equipment. And there is very good reason for this because, like me, for example, I can easily create a long form piece of content like this YouTube video or a drawing video or whatever it is and splice it up into a bunch of 15-second clips. And it's very easy to conform this horizontal resolution into the vertical 16:9 aspect ratio. So all I have to really do is edit one long YouTube video and then pick 10 to 15 clips to then repurpose onto TikTok and Reels. This is exactly how I repurpose my content and how I'm able to post every single day and pretty often on almost all platforms while being pretty much a one-woman show. It's basically how I avoid overworking myself and burning myself out, because that is more dangerous than what however many potential followers I could hope to gain. Not only that, let's say you don't want to repurpose content. You want to make reels specifically for Instagram. By editing off the app, it makes it so easy to edit to the music. And when you are editing to music, it typically does a lot better on Instagram Reels because people are pretty much dazzled by the fancy editing that you're doing. My next creation tip has to do with adding captions. Lately, I've noticed Instagram Reels has been getting a little bit more saturated, which means you have a little bit more competition, so it's harder to grow. Everyone who jumped immediately on Instagram Reels when I told them to probably got a whole lot of engagement, a whole lot more followers, and a lot of views. Now it's so much harder. So in order to compete in this growing competitive part of Instagram, you need to be adding captions to your videos. This is the main difference between Instagram and TikTok. TikTok, people are on there specifically with the sound on, looking at videos, scrolling for hours at a time. With Instagram Reels, some people are watching it on their feed. Some people are just scrolling through it while they're on the toilet. Some people are at work. So most of the time, Instagram defaults the sound to being off. So if you are saying something to camera, or you are lip syncing, or you are doing anything, you need to be adding captions to explain what you're doing. Otherwise, people don't really have the attention span to figure out or even to turn the sound on. So you need people to be reading the captions. That way they can watch your video all the way through. Let me actually show you how to do this. When you go over to Instagram, head over to Reels and then create a new reel. I already have some reels ready because they are being repurposed from my TikTok. First, let me add the clip to my timeline. You add this clip, hit add, then press the forward button to go to the next screen. So as the video plays, I want to add some captions explaining what I am doing in this video. So you tap the text icon and I will write something. Time to add some tone. Hit done. So now I've added type. But the thing is, I only want the type to play at a certain time. So I tap the bottom where it says time. Here you can set where you want the text to appear and disappear. So I only want it on screen for a couple of seconds before it goes away. You hit done, and there you have it. Then you can share to Reels. So once you've researched and created your reels and you're ready to post, I highly recommend that you post your reels to your feed. And I know, I was very hesitant to do this as well, especially with the amount of engagement I used to get on my reels. But now that it's so much more competitive, you want as many eyes on your reels as possible. One of the biggest reasons I really wanted to avoid posting my reels onto my feed is that it looks kind of ugly because you can choose technically what frame of the video to use for the cover when it's posted to your Instagram account, but oftentimes it's not very attractive and it kind of makes your feed look a little bit cluttered if you care about the look of your feed. One way to get around this is to add a custom cover photo. So you can really, if you really want to hit reels hard, design a cover photo or image for your reels so it looks a little bit like a curated photo on your Instagram feed. That way people are enticed to tap on your reel and actually watch it. And when people find you from the explore page or wherever they're finding you from, when they go to your profile, your feed doesn't look jarring or cluttered. I've also found with some experimenting that my reels that I do share to feed tend to get a lot more engagement than my normal reels if I just posted it to reels. If you want to learn how to use social media to grow your online business, check out my free guide, 8 Steps to Launch Your Online Store. Head over to honeynowson.com to help support this channel by buying some merch. I've added some new prints and some new products recently, and I hope you like it. Check out these other videos next to learn how to grow your social media. If you like the video, jingle all my bells and buttons for more art and entrepreneurship type videos, and don't forget to dare to dream.